course, I'm not originally Iranian. I'm from Kashmir, but I'm living for a long time with Iranians, and I feel myself as one of as one of the members of Iranian Brothers. That's that's reality. Of course, when someone is seeing that, the media world is, you know, making a false face, of you in the nations, it hurts our, you know, hearts, because it's not the reality. You can ask it from any of these members of these delegates who have traveled to Iran for their first time, and you will understand that they were shocked when they entered Iran, and they understood that everything was totally different from what they had heard about Iran. It's not a reality. Actually, it's an agenda, and it's propaganda against Iran being done by, you know, Western countries and Western powers, because they are really frightened of what happened after the revolution in Iran, and it's going to become an inspiration for all people of the world, what Imam Khomeini, what the movement of Imam Khomeini did at that time, and made a symbol for resistance among the people and countries of the world. Of course, they are afraid of this, and there is no other way. They have, you know, tested all the ways for, you know, confronting Iran while it was sanctions, while it was, you know, imposed war in Iran, while it was, you know, political efforts against Iran. But they were, you know, defeated in all these fields. And at this time, they are starting a media war against Iran to show a false face of Iran. And but I'm sure the truth will come out, and they cannot put the sun always after and behind the clouds, and it will be a prayer once, and everyone will understood it, inshallah. Please come and listen. Who is what is terrorism? What do you mean by terrorism? And who is really exporting violence and terrorism in the world? What's going on in the region of Middle East? Middle East is thousands of kilometers far from USA. And USA's soldiers are all over Middle East, in Persian Gulf, in Afghanistan, in Iraq, and they have got, you know, camps in Azerbaijan and other Turkey and other countries surrounding Iran. So who is exporting violence and terrorism? And please tell us, what has Iran done against them? What has Iran done against them during these years? That they're blaming Iran for exporting terrorism. Bring the flag. It's just a symbol. Flag for people of Iran is not symbol of nation of America. It's symbol of government of America. That although there has been some change in the government, but the policies against Islamic world and the policy against Iran has been always the same during all these decades. When people of Iran are burning the flag of America, they are not going to insult the people of America. Surely the people of America are different from the government of America. They mean to say, we are burning the policies of a government which is going to export violence, export killing, going to kill innocent people, fight by the pretext of fighting against terrorism, killing lots of people, lots of civilians. So how can this be justified? How can this be justified? My main, you know, message for the people of America is to please come and think about the issues, except from the influence of your medias. Think people. The motto and slogan of people of America is liberty. Okay, please liberate your mind. Liberate your mind from these medias, from these, and think and judge about the issue of Iran, issue of Middle East, issue or all the issues related to Islamic world with a free mind, and then decide. Do not have, you know, prejudgments about them. Come and decide about them. You see the reality. You are going to face about Iran. You are going to face about the Islamic world being made by your medias in your mind. But if possible for you, please come to Iran and see Iran. Come to Islamic countries and see. Come to Muslims and please make relations with Muslims. See how they are. If you feel any violence, any kind of terrorism inside them, I do believe it's an ignorant among the, you know, Western people. Made by your media, imposed by your media in the mind of the people of their countries. I just want to tell them that put you as the Palestinian, put yourself inside the Palestinians. What would you do if you were inside the Palestinians? Just think for a little bit, forget all about your, you know, nationality, forget all about, you know, your you know, government and all about your, you know, nationality and your religion. Just think that if you was an Arab Palestinian living in Palestine, and what happened to them was going to happen about you, what would you do at that time? You, I mean, said, say, yeah, what would you do at that time? Just put yourself inside of, instead of them. I think anyone who refers to his own, you know, origin, own nature, will have the same answer. Palestinian people haven't got any other choice exists except resistance. There's nothing for them to, what can they do? For 6 decades they are waiting for the help of, you know, countries, but didn't, nothing happened for the help of UN, nothing happened for the help of, you know, international organization, nothing happened. And at this time they are on their own knees fighting and resisting, and by this resistance the awakeness of people has been, has appeared among the people of the world, and we are seeing our movement is just a result of what resistance in Palestine did. If they were not going to resist, we were not going to have such a kind of movements, because they did that resistance, they become a civil. And this I want to say to Israeli people, think a little bit what your government and what your regime is, did and is doing and is going to do against the people of Palestine.